Colgate Comedy Hour. Starring Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis. With their special guests, Kitty Callan. And Robert Strauss, Danny Arnold, Pepe Mano, Gold Cup, and Bird. Presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feet Company, makers of Halo Shampoo. Colgate Dental Cream. Ajax Cleanser. And Palmolive Soap. And now, the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a most auspicious day for the National Broadcasting Company, and in a moment, I will tell you why. Now, as representative of the country's leading newspapers, you are about to see the latest and greatest achievement in television receivers. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you life-size television. Now, for our first demonstration of life-size television, in Studio D at NBC, where Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis are performing, we will continue our experiment of life-size television with the inimitable Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis. Lights, please.
We're very happy to be here on this closed television circuit for all you NBC executives, aren't we?
We certainly are.
See? And we're very happy that you were able to see the show.
We certainly are.
And we would like to conclude the program right now by doing a dance. Isn't that true?
We certainly are. I'll do the dance first.
Why don't you start?
Well, here we go. No tap.
No tap.
No tap. Just a regular old heavy shoes.
Very
the,
good.
The old man can go pretty good.
Yes, that's very nice.
How come you dance much faster?
I'm so much younger.
Pretty good, you know. Oh, toe dancer.
I'm a regular ballerina.
You can say that again.
Time step.
Yes, one. Through a spot this. Stop.
Oh, we're so bestabbled. How about the Charleston? You start that off.
What's going on in here?
What's going on around here?
Who are these guys anyway?
Hey, look at the little one. He's jerky.
Hey, what are you two guys doing? What is this?
Yeah,
me?
Come here, you. Yeah, hey, come here, you. Come here.
What is it?
Get out of here.
You get out of here.
No, I told you to get out
you
of here.
You can't tell me to get out. I work here with my
right
partner. Who do you think
hey,
you...
Hey, listen to
oh,
me.
Oh, shut up. Oh,
I you to tell you that you...
Who are you guys anyway?
Who are we? We happen to be Martin and Lewis.
You're Martin and Lewis? Well, who do you think we are?
You're just a couple of thieves.
Who's he calling a fink?
All right, we've had enough of this. Now, you two get out of here before we throw you out.
You throw us out? You want to get tough, huh?
Yeah, I'll get tough with
well,
you.
I'll give you one easy then. How do you like that? I started with us.
Are you all right?
Are you
yeah.
okay?
Sure, I'm okay. Just take care of those guys.
Yeah, get those guys.
We ain't afraid of these guys.
What are you
going
to do?
We're going to get you guys.
We're going to get you guys.
Yeah, you better watch your step.
You better watch your step.
Well, we ain't afraid.
Just come here. You did it again, right?
I didn't do nothing.
Shut up.
You did it again, right?
Well,
I don't even want to converse with you. Just introduce my song. Maybe after the song, I may talk with you. But right now, just keep quiet. Introduce the song. You go, why, you miserable. I ought to let you.
What are you blaming me? Will you? Ryan. Hello there. Well, I don't care. This is all for fun. But, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to do something that, we have never done this before because, Dean and I don't make a habit introducing people, but in this particular respect, it's something special. So I would like to just say that from my hometown, Irvington, New Jersey, a very sweet lady came here tonight to see the show, and I'd like to have my mom stand up and take a bow. Everyone does it, Mom. Just a quick bow, sweetheart. Come on.
Colgate Palm Olive Peat Company announces Nature's Chlorophyll is in every cake of palm olive soap. Nature's Chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green. No therapeutic claim is made for the chlorophyll, but you should know this about palm olive. Doctors have proved that Palm Olive's beauty plan brings most women lovelier complexions in 14 days. Gently massage Palmolive Soap's extra mild, pure lather onto your skin for just a minute, three times a day. Rinse and pat dry, that's all. But remember, doctors have proved Palmolive's beauty results. Yes, Palmolive brings out beauty while it cleans your skin. Today, get Palmolive, the chlorophyll green soap with the pure white lather. Same familiar wrapper, same low price. Yes, Nature's Chlorophyll is in every cake of palm olive soap. Nature's Chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green.
Sorry, Lockman, did you get that film I asked for?
Got it, Ernest, Jim.
Good. Put it on.
Okay, Mac. Roll it.
I want you to pay particular attention to this piece right here.
Yes, sir, S.J. He was a great Tarzan. Look at that form. Why, he was born to be a Tarzan.
You're right, Lockman. But unfortunately, good Tarzans aren't born every minute. I have an idea. That's why I asked you down here. We've got to have a reservoir of fresh Tarzans. You know, we've got the best Tarzan in the business working for us right now, but it's dangerous work. Suppose something happens to him.
Gosh, S.J., I never thought of that.
You know, Lockman, we're going to have to train Tarzans. We're going to have to teach them everything we know.
Sounds great, S.J., but how are you going to do it?
Simple. Lockman, we're going to start a school for Tarzans.
S.J., you're a genius. Gosh, a school for Tarzans.
All right, you're Tarzan. Here, no, you gotta take the knife the right way. You know what I mean? Now, see, you.
Me, Tarzan!
Open. And you're going up there, aren't you?
Yeah, boy.
Would you mind coming down here? I want to talk to you.
Huh?
Come down here. I want to talk to you.
Okay. I'll be right down.
Yeah, I'm waiting.
Yeah, it'll only be another minute.
Yeah, all right, all right. Come on up.
Come on up.
Come on up.
Come on up. Wait! I saw your newspaper ad, and it said in the newspaper that you need Tarzans who are fearless, who can run and swim and kill and get animals and strangle them and kill them and all that. And that's why I'm here.
Why?
I can swim.
Listen, you know, in order to be a Tarzan, you got to be tough and fearless and afraid of nothing at all.
I'm afraid of nothing, boy.
Okay, now go take your clothes off.
Here.
I'm out of here. Go take them off. Put on a Tarzan outfit.
Oh, for a minute, I thought...
All right, up here. Now, we're going to take a little... Did you see this dummy? You want to see what you learned in the past 2 weeks? We're going to attack him, right? All right. Crouch. Now, signals 47, 48, and I say, fight! Attack! 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 That's all right. Back to your normal work now.
Got to build up the muscles, you know.
The whole thing? You didn't leave anything back there?
This is everything.
This is it?
Yeah.
Wow. All right. Now, first of all, you got to learn how to enter a Tarzan room. You just can't come walking in.
Oh, well, I walked in.
No, you got to know how to... McCluskey.
Yes, sir.
Show him how to enter. Watch this very carefully.
Yes. Because
you may not be back this way. There you are. Do that, Spencer.
Oh, boy.
Start from there. Go ahead. Oh, boy. All right. Come on. All right.
Get this out of here.
All right, pick it up.
I want to do something different.
All right, now, you see, right now we got this little dummy we got right here. You know what I mean?
Dummy?
No, this is a little, this little thing. I want you to attack this. You know what I mean?
Oh, this ape.
That's what I said. You're
yeah,
attacking.
Well, I'm scared. I don't want to.
Don't be a scared. Come here. This is a dummy. Nothing to it.
Oh, huh.
Just go ahead. Show me how you attack.
Oh, all righty. I'm scared.
Scared of what? It's a dummy. This is a dummy.
Oh.
Go ahead. Show. Look at this. What? See? Get out of here. He'll kill both of us. Come on.
No, I don't like that, Mr. Martin.
Forget it. Let me see what you know about these animals over here.
Oh, I know. That's a mouse.
Mouse?
Yeah, a hippopotamouse. Oh, that's the red. Wow! Look at those crazy red tonsils.
All right, turn up here, wife. Come on, a little breathing exercise. So you can do that victory cry. Let him in. You can let him in here. All right now. Inhale.
Oh, I don't like that.
You don't like it?
No. I'll stand this way and do it.
All right, let's turn around, fellas. Yeah.
No, I...
Inhale!
No!
Exhale.
Oh, I don't like that at all.
Inhale!
Oh! Exhale!
Come here, let me see. Hello. What is it? The old car, he's sick. We'll send him to the car over right away. Yeah, we have a lot of them. Okay, let's be time.
All right, exhale.
Oh, the whole head. Oh, the whole head is bleeding. Oh, the head is bleeding.
What would you say if I told you that we picked you for the next Tarzan?
Yeah.
No, me, sir, you.
Oh, what a thrill. I will be the best Tarzan in the world. I'll show you, sir, that I'll do honor to the name Tarzan.
Kitchen sink up to twice as easy, twice as fast.
Use Ajax, boom, boom, the foaming cleanser. Boom, 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 boom. Get things clean just like a whiz. You'll stop paying the elbow tax when you start cleaning with Ajax.
So use Ajax, boom, boom,
the foaming cleanser.
Boom, boom, boom.
Fluff the dirt right down the drain.
Boom, 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 boom.
Ajax leaves no gritty cleanser scum in tub or sink.
So use Ajax,
boom, boom,
the foaming cleanser.
Boom, 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 boom.
Get things clean just like a whiz.
Boom, 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 boom. Remember, Colgate's Ajax foams as it cleans.
Ajax cuts grease faster than any other leading cleanser.
Ajax polishes as it cleans. Mmm, and it smells good, too.
So you. Ajax.
Why not see for yourself how Ajax cleans your kitchen sink up to twice as easy and twice as fast as any other leading cleanser. Get two cans for your kitchen and bathroom. Ajax, the foaming action cleanser.
Halo Shampoo presents the real inside story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Young lady, you've eaten all of Junior's porridge.
And busted his chair.
And slept in my bed.
Of course. I'm supposed to. I'm Goldilocks.
She's not Goldilocks. Her hair isn't pretty.
Let's wash it and find out.
Not with that. Soaping doll's hair. Halo glorifies it.
Because Halo shampoo's not a soap or a cream.
So it can't leave dulling soap film.
Gee, look at the suds.
If she's really Goldilocks, Halo shampoo will soon prove it.
Now, let's take a look.
It is Goldilocks. Halo, everybody, halo. Halo is the shampoo that glorifies your hair. So halo shampoo, halo.
Remember, soaping doll's hair. Halo glorifies it. Leaves it fragrant, dandruff-free, and wonderfully easy to manage.
So halo, everybody, halo. Halo shampoo, halo.
Next time you buy a shampoo, remember, soaping dulls hair, halo glorifies it. Reveals all your hair's naturally lovely highlights with your very first shampoo. Yes, next time, be sure to get Halo, America's favorite shampoo.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we have two distinctly different schools of child psychology, the old and the new. The old school hews to the principle of spare the rod and spoil the child. They believe that a child must be punished, that he can be spanked or scolded. The new school, however, insists that a child should be allowed to follow his natural instincts. These people have read books on how to raise their children. They've learned never to spank their child for fear of frustrating him. These are the parents of the old school. They have never spared the rod. And when it comes to their children, there can be no doubt as to who holds the upper hand. Here we find the parents of the new school. They have allowed their child to follow his natural instincts. He has been brought up by the book.
What are we going to do about Rodney?
Will you stop worrying, Paul? Dr. Marvin says he's going to grow out of this stage.
Dr. Marvin, why don't you stop with this book? Dr. Marvin says I should play horsey with him. I played horsey with him this morning.
Well, so what?
Look at this. He wore spurs. Look what he uses. Look what he plays with. See this? Radium juice. Look at this. Busted rings. How do you like that? Stewed roads and seed cutter oil.
Oh, stop.
Other little kid. Come here. I want to finish the scene. Other little kid. They have, you know what they have? Dogs and cats for pets. What does he have? Our monster has termites.
Oh, Paul, stop it, will you?
What do you mean, stop
it? Dr. Marvin says he has to have freedom of expression.
Freedom of the press he should have.
Besides, you know how sweet he can be sometimes.
Him sweet?
Right now he's in his room playing with his little friends.
Probably burning.
It's my house, and I can do what I want. I own it all. It's my house. Now, I don't even want you to hang around here no more. Get out of here and take your kid brother with you. Get out of here! All of you! And don't come back till I send my men for you. You're going to get a bunch of strikes in my whole lot.
Hello, Daddy, darling.
Darling.
Oh, yeah, to give you a shot.
Hey, Daddy, darling, sweet angel foot. Look at my new hypodermic needle. Oh, goody gumdrop.
Be calm.
It's right here in the book. Just pretend like nothing happened.
That's all. Nothing happened right there.
It says right here on page 47. It says,
hey, what are you reading, Mommy, darling?
We're reading Dr. Marvin's book.
Oh, that's terrific. Did you read that, Daddy dear?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's terrific. You know something, Daddy, that he says about parents? There are actually parents who take their children, kick them and hit them and slap them and beat them and do all those things for them, Daddy.
Stop it. Rodney, when he's talking.
Thank you, Mommy, darling.
What is it they do to their children sometimes, Rodney?
Well, you know, Mommy, that there are parents who pick their children like this and they do all kinds of things.
Thank heavens, he's so uninhibited.
She used to be a good Joe, huh, Dad?
Rodney.
Yes, darling, Daddy.
I don't want you to get upset, but we're all alone.
Oh, that's quite true, Daddy, darling. Uh-huh. Shall we play Mahjong?
No, Mahjong, but I don't want to play it. Look, listen to me.
What, Daddy?
The good book says that you're my flesh and blood.
And I'm so happy.
Good, and I want to prove it.
How, Daddy?
I'm going to cut your throat.
No, Daddy. Daddy, remember Dr. Marvin's book?
I don't care about the book.
Oh, Daddy, Dr. Marvin's book tells off.
You
have to be
book.
Daddy. Pocket size, Daddy. Daddy, remember the book, Daddy. The book, Daddy. Remember, Daddy. Daddy, the book, Daddy. Did it hurt a lot?
The whole hand hurt.
Oh, that's a shame, Daddy.
Hey, I brought you up there. Who are you?
Ah! Daddy! Oh, Daddy!
How did you get those things in your eyes, son? Hi, Frank.
Hi, Paul. How are you?
Oh, hello, Mr. Bird.
Keep an eye on Herbie while I get down to the garage.
Sure, I'll watch Herbie.
And don't let him near that little monster of yours. If that hoodlum just touches my Herbie, just touches him, I'm gonna break your neck. Remember, if he just touches my Herbie.
Frank, don't leave him. He's going to touch him.
I know.
Rodney, you can look at him. You can speak to him. You can sing to him. Don't touch him. You can go around, walk, play games with. Don't touch him, please.
Anything you want. You know, throw him a couple books with. Don't touch him.
He's quaint. No, a nice day for thunder, huh, Herbie? You want to play surgery? Yeah, you're a nice kid, Herbie. Nice. Oh, a nice kid, Herbie. You want to see my termites?
No.
Come on, I'll show you. look at, and these are all mine. My termites, aren't they terrific? I have Artie, Ethel, Max, Frida, Fred, Sam, Bark, and John. Aren't they cute?
What do you want termites for?
They're a lot better than spiders.
Yeah. And I have more fun with them. This is all my chemicals, too. I think I'll mix something. Oh, good. Oh, okay. You know what I'm making now, Herbie?
Tell him to laugh.
This is terrific, Herbie. Look at this. I'm going to make a terrific potion, and when it's all finished, you know what it does, Herbie? It makes things grow. Isn't that terrific? It makes... Looks like Manischewitz. It makes things grow. Come here, Herbie. Watch this. Watch carefully, Herbie. Look. Isn't that... Isn't that terrific, Herbie? You want to try some?
No.
Yeah, come on, Herbie.
No,
just a little bit. It won't help. It won't hurt. Just
no.
A little bit.
No,
Herbie,
try, no.
Try a little bit, Herbie. Try it, Herbie. Try a little bit.
No.
Isn't that terrific? Splendid reaction.
Rodney. Yes, Daddy.
How are you and Herbie getting along?
Oh, fine.
Is that
all right? Yeah, he's all right. He's coughing. My daddy's coming, Herbie. My daddy's Herbie. My daddy.
Hello, Rodney.
Hello, Daddy, darling.
You and Herbie have... you. Where's Herbie?
Who? Herbie? Oh,
Where is Herbie? He was just here, Rodney.
Well, he's around, Daddy.
Around where? Where?
Herbie's...
Where did he go?
I think he took a cab.
Oh, come on now. Dad, go on, look for him. I'll go this way.
Yes, I'll find him, Daddy. I'll find her. Herbie! Oh, Herbie! Herbie, come on out. Hurry up. My daddy's looking for you, Herbie. Hurry up. My daddy's gone. I think he went outside. Are you all right, Herbie?
I feel fine.
Well, that's good, because I didn't want my daddy...
Who'd you think it was?
I knew all the time. Oh, and my daddy sees what I said to you. He'll kill me. Come with me, Herbie. Hurry up. Now, wait outside. Oh.
Hey, Rodney. Where's Herbie? What are you doing?
I'm studying semicode.
All right, forget it. Where's Herbie?
Who, Daddy?
Herbie, look, where is he? I was looking for him. I couldn't find him.
I don't know, Daddy.
You don't know?
No.
Well, we got to find the kid.
Who's he?
Who's who?
Him.
I'm Herbie.
Oh, Herbie! Boy, we've been looking for you. He was in that. I went all around the block. Oh, no.
Dr. Harvey!
Don't hit me, Daddy. He just drank some of my chemical.
Well, let's drink another chemical and see what happens.
Yeah, Daddy. Well, I think if we...
What did you use?
Well, Harvey, Daddy's home.
That's all right.
Where's the papa?
Hide him.
Where's my friend?
Hold him.
Hey, Martin, where's my kid?
I think he took a cab.
Come on, where's my kid?
Mr. Bird, yeah? If I told you where Herbie was, would you hit my daddy?
I sure would.
He's over here.
Oh, no. What happened to my Herbie? I left my Herbie here half an hour ago with a kid like this. What'd you do to my Herbie?
What are you getting excited about?
What am I getting excited about? Every week a new suit. Get home! Bring your mother!
Across the nation, millions of Americans seek the answer to the age-old problem. How to stop unpleasing breath, stop tooth decay. Now comes heartening news from the world of dental science. Comes this proof of performance from research laboratories and clinical experiments.
To stop unpleasing breath, we recommend Colgate Dental Cream. Our scientific tests prove that in 7 out of 10 cases, Colgate's instantly stops unpleasing breath that originates in the mouth. And brushing teeth right after eating with Colgate Dental Cream makes your mouth feel cleaner, longer, gives you a clean, fresh mouth all day long.
Most important in these studies, research reports.
The Colgate way of brushing teeth right after eating is the best home method known to help stop tooth decay. The Colgate way stopped more tooth decay for more people than ever reported in all dentifrice history.
Moreover, pure, white, safe Colgate Dental Cream will not stain or discolor. So always use Colgate Dental Cream because the Colgate way is the most thoroughly proved and accepted home method of oral hygiene known today to stop unpleasing breath, stop tooth decay.
Very kind, ladies and gentlemen. Right about here, we would like to just make mention in our show that a publication that many of you know very well, Look Magazine, has been tremendously wonderful to Dean and myself in the past. We'd like to say that on December the 16th, the new issue of Look is a picture of Dean and I. We'd like for you to buy the magazine because it's a wonderful story. What are you laughing? There's a wonderful story in the magazine about our wonderful boss, Mr. Hal Wallace, who made the picture here, The Stooge. The Stooge is a wonderful motion picture that Dean and I take a lot of pride in because it's the first dramatic comedy we've ever made. We'd like for you to look at it. You're nasty, all of you. But it is the first dramatic comedy, and it opens at 675-some-odd theaters on New Year's Eve night for a premiere showing, and then in your local theaters in January. So buy Look Magazine and watch for The Stooge. Right now, I would like to say that you've been so wonderful
We would like to carry on with the proceedings by introducing Dean.
Excuse me, Mr. Lewis. Here's the 10 notes.
Thank you very much. Excuse me just a moment. Oh, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we were reminded earlier in the program that NBC would like for the entire network to cooperate with the police department and with the FBI authorities about a little old lady who seems to have been holding up banks around town. We'd like to say that, seriously, this is the most important matter because it's protecting you and your money. We would like to say that the police bureau sent down a picture. We would like to show to you. If you see this woman, please contact your local authorities. Here is the picture of the woman, so if you ever see it... I have to stop you from laughing. That's not proper to stop people from laughing, but this is important. If you see the woman, please contact the local authorities. Now, we would like to carry on with the show by introducing a young...
Ma. Ma. You needed money, Ma. Why didn't you call me, Ma?
What did you do, Ma? What did you do?
Right now,
Jerry and I'd like to do something we haven't done on our Colgate TV shows. I'm going to ask Jerry to sing a song in his own legitimate voice. And he's going to do it in his own voice. Jerry, would you come on out here? Here he is, the old boy. Jerry, now you're going to sing this song. We rehearsed it and everything.
Yeah, but I'm a little nervous, yeah.
No, you shouldn't be nervous.
Oh, I am nervous.
Oh, no. Now, listen to me. Look, now I'm going to conduct this for you, right?
Oh, great white father.
Oh, thank you. I'll conduct it. You step any... Where do you want to stand?
Right here so they can hear every word.
Every word, they
yeah,
should hear.
Yeah, I'm nervous, really.
Nervous, you shouldn't be there.
Hey, Ma, Pa, Aunt Dora, Sylvia,
yeah,
Edna.
All right.
I don't like any of them, but I said hello.
All right. Now, you all ready?
Yeah. Please. My face got in back of your hand.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Because of you, there's a song in my heart. Because of you.
You were very good, Jerry.
Yeah, and they were nice to me.
All right, I think that you and I, well, say something because they were so nice to you.
Well, I mean, they're nice to both of us and all that.
Yeah?
Yeah, and...
So?
Really swell and everything, and I should say something nice, yeah. You have been wonderful to Dean and I all the time, and especially this show. If you've liked it and you like Dean and I and what we did, we'd appreciate it if you'd send us both a couple of dollars.
Oh, God. Send us a couple of dollars. We get paid for this.
Yeah?
We give most of it away, but we get paid for this.
No, but you
shouldn't insult me like that.
Well, I just asked.
Well, don't do a thing like that. Apologize.
If
found it, Yai.
We're certain you.
Well, I just said that
I... don't just said. Apologize. $2 you ought to be out of your nitwit. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm awfully sorry, and I can understand how Dean feels, and due to the fact that he doesn't want any money, send just $1 for me. Oh.
Oh, that's a little number we like to do, huh? I say that no one who don't. I know that no one who say, but way down. I say you will go. I know no one say that. I say, why do I go way down upon the Pony River?
Come on, Chair. Do this nice little song.
We may be able to do this number. You know the number?
Do I know the number?
We heard 3 days, write the number ourselves, knock our brains out, he says, do you know the number?
Do you?
No, I don't.
I don't know the number.
I just asked for the melody. What's so funny?
Dirty picture.
Another show's done. I've sung a song or two. My partner with the poodle cut as usually came through. I want to tell you, Jer.
Yeah?
You really went to town.
Uh-huh.
And any time I do a show, feel free to hang around.
Oh, you'll never get away, 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 you'll never get away.
I'm very glad you asked, and I'll be there, you bet. Cause I can't see the show at home, I ain't got a set. I count my lucky stars each time I hear you sing. And Dean, I wouldn't trade you for Tacomos and a Bing.
Oh, you'll never get away, 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 you'll never get away.
I'm glad that we agree.
Yes, sir, we really do.
I hope we'll be together, Jeff.
Till I'm as old as you.
Ha-ha, you didn't turn a page then.
Boy, how the time just goes.
Remember your old haircut, Jer.
Remember your old nose.
Oh, you'll never get away, 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 you'll never get away.
Hey, 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 hey. Wow, 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 wow.
I think you both forgot. With all your Hammond's meal,
yes,
where would you fellas be today without your old Dick Stabile, eh?
Oh, you'll never get away, you'll never get away, you'll never get away, you'll never get away, you'll never get away. December 28th. Oh, you'll never get away, 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 you'll never get away
Chair. I mean, it was real sweet of you to bring your mother out here like that. I'm glad we all had our pocketbooks closed. Just one thing.
Ladies and gentlemen.
You tell them. See, right now, we just got to sign 2 minutes.
Oh, well, we don't care. No, no, a minute and a half, oh, we can kill that in a week.
Easy.
I'd like to ask very quickly for a wonderful round of applause for the young man who's been with our organization for 5 years, and we certainly couldn't do anything without him, the very wonderful Dick Stabile in the orchestra. Ladies and gentlemen, starting December the 1st, the campaign for research for the Muscular Dystrophy Association is on. We would like to thank you first for the wonderful things you've been doing for MDA since we've told you about them. The tremendous monies coming in is just wonderful. We'd like you to continue, and as of December the 1st, we're trying our best to build a research foundation so that we can wipe the disease off the face of the earth. We thank you from the bottoms of our hearts because you've been just so wonderful.
And don't forget now next week, folks, great guy, wonderful comedian, Mr. Bob Hope. Robert Hope will be on
on the Colgate Comedy Hour. There. And he's very funny and a very sweet guy, so please tune in. So until we see you again, on behalf of
Dino Crosetti.
Dino Crosetti and Joseph Levitch, we thank you so much. Good night and God bless you.
The Colgate Comedy Hour has been presented by Halo Shampoo, Colgate Dental Cream, Ajax Cleanser, and Palmolive Soap. Tonight's cast were Rose Plummer, Max Farmer, John Shawley, Byron Kane, Joseph Leon, and Steve Calvert. Special lyrics were by Danny Arnold. Be sure and tune in again next week at the same time when the Colgate Comedy Hour will star Bob Hope with his guests Tony Martin and Francis Langford. 2 weeks from tonight, your stars will be Abbott and Costello. And 3 weeks from tonight, Ray Bolger will make his starring debut on the Colgate Comedy Hour. The Colgate Comedy Hour has been chosen to be shown overseas through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. This is Hal Sawyer saying goodnight for the Colgate Comedy Hour, which has been presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feed Company, makers of quality products since 1806.